Praise the Lord. Greetings to everyone in the name of Jesus. I thank God in the name of Jesus for giving me an opportunity to be with you today in this video. So I welcome all brothers and sisters, those who are watching. The grace of the Lord is upon everyone. Today morning, God has given me a word to share with you from the book of Ephesians chapter 1, 19 and 20. I welcome all brothers and sisters. The peace of the Lord is upon you. Welcome, Sister Norma Gaza. The peace of the Lord is upon you. More grace into your life, Sister Norma Gaza. Welcome, Brother Richards. I see financial stability, overflowing financial. I see abundance, a financial breakthrough coming. Brother Richards, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome, Sister Norma Gaza. Hallelujah. So, I welcome all brothers and sisters, those who are watching. The grace of the Lord is upon you. God is going to have you a good seat. So, whatever you are doing, God is going to establish you. Hallelujah. Whatever you are doing, God is going to establish it. Hallelujah. So this is the word. It is that establishment is going to happen because of your faith in the power of God. Hallelujah. Welcome, Pastor Lee Solomon. You are going to be established. Hallelujah. You are going to be established. So to everyone I am saying, what you are doing, you are going to be established. Maybe some of you are telling that I have no address. I have no office. I have no office of my own. I have no address of my own. But I tell you that you have an office and it is going to be revealed. But till this time it was not revealed because you were in the training period, you were in the probation period. Now the God has been selected you. God has seen that you have passed all the tests. You have passed all the tests in the wilderness. So God is going to, Sister Jelisa Wolford, I see the Lord is saying that you have passed all the tests. You have been in the wilderness. I sense you have been in the wilderness. So the Lord is having grace upon your life. So you are having an office. So you are in the wilderness, but you have passed the test. To everyone I am telling, hallelujah. Maybe you are not having any office, or you are in a rented building, or you are in the wilderness, you are in the training period. But today I tell you, the Lord has confirmed your calling. How many of you believe? It depends upon your faith. So I welcome all brothers and sisters, Sister Mona Tubu, Sister Remya Rai, all brothers and sisters. So I see there is an increase in the anointing of the Lord. Hallelujah. So I'm going to read that words, because before that, let us close our eyes for a moment to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray in the name of Jesus, bring those your children according to your will to hear the word of God. Let it minister from you, and I submit myself. You use my tongue, Lord, in the name of Jesus. You give me accuracy in revelation and prophecy. May the power and fire of God be released. People be healed and delivered. Only in the name of Jesus be exalted, Lord. Let there be clarity in every network and in every picture, sound, everything. No distraction, Lord. Let your power be released and everyone be healed and delivered in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God be released in the name of Jesus. Amen. So the Lord has given me a word to share with you. It is from the book of Ephesians. Today morning, I asked the Lord what to share. So the Lord has given this word, Ephesians 1:19. It says, what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places? Hallelujah. So something great is going to happen in your life because every word there is a hidden power. There is a hidden power in behind every word. It will be revealed and it will come into those only who believe. That's why the verse is saying, according to the working of his mighty power for those who believe. If you believe today, this time, wherever you are, if you believe, it is going to happen. You will see the deliverance at the time when you are watching this video. That is the power of God. I will tell you, what is the exceeding greatness of his power toward us? It is the exceeding greatness. There is no limit. Exceeding greatness of his power toward us who believe. Who believe according to the working of his mighty power, which he raised Christ Jesus from the dead and seated him on the heavenly places. So you must believe that there is power. You are speaking in tongues. It is not only for just to speak in tongues, but there is power when you open your mouth and speak in tongues. There will be power releasing from your mouth. How many of you believe? That power will give a breakthrough in your life. It depends upon your faith. There is no limitation. So when you have a negative situation, when you are in a trial, when you are in the wilderness, when you are passing through a financial problem or a family problem or something related to the ministry, when you open your mouth and speak in tongues, not only the tongues you are speaking, it is not just the sound, but power is released. Power, that's what the verse is saying, exceeding greatness. Paul is praying for the church, for the Ephesians church, to people to know the exceeding. People are praying for a deliverance. Ephesians church are praying for a deliverance. They wanted a deliverance in the financial area, family setup, and in every area. So they are crying for a deliverance. But Paul understood one thing: they are actually rich. They are actually rich in everything, but their inner eyes are closed. They have no faith. They have no faith in their power of God. So they are not having any deliverance. Today, when you have received Jesus Christ as your Savior, realize one thing. At the moment, God has given you all the gifts. So you have to open your eyes and see that you are not an ordinary person. You are something special chosen by God. So you have given, when you have received Jesus Christ as Savior, he has taken everything on the cross. Understand one thing, you are healed. But if only you believe in the power of God, if only you believe that God can heal you, then only that healing will come upon you. So Paul realized one thing, that these people are actually having all the gifts, they are rich in everything. But still they are crying for a breakthrough. They are still crying for a deliverance. So Paul is praying, let everyone know the exceeding greatness. That's what the verse is saying. Hallelujah. I will read. And what is the exceeding? So we can see that from the 15th verse when you read, he was praying for the Ephesians church to know, to have their eyes of understanding open, to have the knowledge of God. So he was praying let everyone know the exceeding greatness, of the power. So today the exceeding greatness of power is coming upon your life. So I will read one verse, Colossians 2:12. What does it say? There also it is saying, buried with him in baptism. So Paul is saying, we are buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God who raised him from. So here also Paul is saying that it is through faith. So these all miracles will happen when you have faith in the power of God. So it is not just speaking in tongues, But sir, something beyond that. So what we say, the Acts 2:24, I will read that. Whom God raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that he should be held by it. So you must read this word, Acts 2:24. It says, it was not possible that he should be held by it. Hallelujah. So I was speaking that those who believe in the power of God, there will be surely a deliverance. Acts 2:24, it says that it is impossible for him to be held inside the cave, because it was impossible. So it is impossible for you to be in this state right now, how many of you, because you are going to have a breakthrough. It is, the devil cannot help you. It is impossible. It depends upon, that's why I was saying, it depends upon those who have faith, those who believe. Ephesians 1:19-20 says, you must know the exceeding greatness of his power by faith. And Colossians 2:12 also says, Christ was raised by the power of God, and the same power will raise us also. The same power will deliver us also by those who believe. Those who believe. Hallelujah. Those who have the faith in God. Those who have the faith in Jesus. So, Acts 2:24 also is saying, it is impossible, impossible for the body of Jesus to be held. It is impossible for Jesus to be held in the cave. So when the power of God came, it break the chains. So it was impossible for Peter and Paul to be in the prison for a long time, because they were praising God, they were believing in the power of God. So the devil cannot, the authorities cannot help Peter and Paul in the prison. So when the power of God came, when the angels were released, they were released. So today I tell you, if anyone is saying, I have no breakthrough. Somebody watching the video is saying, I have no breakthrough. No. You know the name of Jesus. Every name has a meaning. The name of Jesus is deliverer. The name of Jesus is deliverer. So when you receive in Jesus, you are delivered. So it depends upon your faith. Some people take the baptism. Some even receive Holy Spirit. They speak in tongues. They speak in tongues when they come to Sunday. At home also they speak in tongues. But they don't believe in the power. So they are just speaking in tongues. But only if you believe, only if you have faith. When you open your mouth and look into your negative things and speaking tongues, the Lord will release the power. So it is impossible for you to be in this situation. Hallelujah. Sister Norma Grasa, the Lord is saying, it is impossible for you to be in this situation. So I see the Lord is releasing the power, and you are going to have a breakthrough in your life. It is impossible for you to be held in this situation. So you are moving. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I see the boundaries are extended, Brother Richards. Hallelujah. I see like the boundaries are extended. It is impossible for the enemy to be held in the position. Hallelujah, Brother Richards. To everyone, those who are watching. So it depends upon your faith, because the Lord's hand is upon you. More grace upon you. You are going into the next level. Everyone, those who are watching, the Lord's grace is upon you. So, Paul, when he visited the Ephesian church, he realized one thing, that they are coming to the church. They are rich externally, but their inner eyes are closed. They have no understanding. They have no faith in the power. So Paul was praying for them to have understanding, to have the inner eyes open, so that they will realize, they will understand the power of God. So today, if anyone is saying that I need a deliverance, today if you understand the power of God, if you believe in the power of God, today the devil cannot make you stagnant. The devil cannot hold you in that place. Surely there is a promotion. Yasina Sak sister, I see a promotion in your ministry. I see you are doing a ministry. So there is a promotion. There are many challenges coming in your life. The Lord is throwing everything apart and making you moving. Whatever that is stagnant, it is impossible for you to stay. I see a promotion. Shakarandistube. So the God is going to bless everyone. It depends upon your faith. Hallelujah. David cannot stay in the jungle. He cannot hide in the caves for a long time, because he had the anointing. He had the anointing to become the king of Israel. So the enemy tried to chase him, and he was hiding. He was hiding in the jungle. He was hiding in the forest. He was hiding in the caves, because he was afraid of the enemy. The enemy was trying to kill him, but he had the anointing. So it is impossible for David to stay long in the cave and in the forest. So he should come out. That is the anointing. That is the power of God. How many of you believe? So it was impossible for the enemy to have David in the forest for a long time. So when the anointing came to burst out, when the anointing came to explode, he was placed in the right position. Hallelujah. Here also the verse is saying that Jesus was raised and seated in the heavenly places. Jesus was raised from the... It is not Jesus to stay inside the cave for more than three days. So it was impossible for the enemy to help Jesus there. So when the time came, when the power began to burst and explode, Jesus was resurrected and he was seated in the heavenly places. The same was David was hiding from the enemy. He was crying for a deliverance. He was hiding himself in the caves and in the forest. But the enemy cannot held him for a long time in the forest and cave, because he had the anointing to become the king of Israel. So everyone, those who are realizing, you are speaking in tongues. It is not just speaking in tongues, because there is an anointing upon you. How many of you? There is a calling upon you. How many of you understand? Oh, Shakaram, you have a calling. So the enemy cannot help you in the wilderness for a long time. Those who do not believe, they cannot reach the destination. But those who believe, there will be a resurrection. There will be a placement in the right position. So those who are having no office, you are going to be seated in the right office. Those who are in the wilderness, you are going to be seated in the right place. How many of, because the enemy cannot hold you back. The enemy cannot make you stagnant. You are going to move. Today the power has released. Today the fire has released. How many of you believe? It depends upon you. The telephone call is coming. Hallelujah. The messenger is opening, and the messenger, you will see a miracle in the messenger. It depends upon your faith. Don't limit the power of God. The WhatsApp is going to do a miracle in your life, not because of WhatsApp, but because of the power of God. It depends upon your faith. The place where you are, the local place where you are residing, is going to do a miracle. It is not because of the place, but because you believe in the power of God. How many of you believe? So the messenger is going to do a miracle. The WhatsApp and Zoom is going to do a miracle. Your ministry is going to be positioned. Some great things are going to happen. It depends upon when you are watching this live video. The Lord is doing something you cannot see, but by by your inner eyes, you open and see. After this session, you will hear a miracle. Hallelujah. So, your life, when you believe in the power of God, every day is a miracle. Hallelujah. Even maybe you are in the training period, it is a miracle. Hallelujah. So, you have been already delivered, but you are in the wilderness, but today it is the promotion day. Hallelujah. Because for a long time you have been held. David was hiding cave and the forest. So he was, but there was a seat for him because the Lord anointed him through Samuel the prophet that he will become the king of Israel. So when the time of David came, he was seated in the right place on the throne. He was seated on as the king, on the king's seat. So the enemy cannot hold him more in the forest. So maybe you are in the wilderness. Believe that today is the day. Today is the day. You can repent if anyone is saying, I have many things, I want to repent. You can repent right now. Because Jesus has said in the book of John 7:6, Jesus is saying, my time has not come, but it is time for you always. Jesus says, my time has not come, but it is time for you always. That's why in the village of Cana, you know, there was a miracle. When the wine was run out, it was not the time for Jesus to do the miracle, but he was moved by the mother of Jesus, Mary. So he demonstrated, he manifested his power, and the water became wine. Today, maybe somebody is saying, one of the prophets have told me that my time is not come. But if you believe, Jesus says, John 7:6, my time has not come, but it is time for you always. It depends upon your faith. Today you are going to see the breakthrough. How many of you believe? Hallelujah. So, every day I am seeing my miracles. Every day I am seeing miracles. Because what I am preaching, I believe that you are also seeing the miracles every day, because you are here, you are watching the video. So those who believe, the exceeding greatness of power is coming. Those who have faith, the exceeding unlimited power is coming in your life. So the enemy cannot make you stagnant. The enemy cannot stay you in the wilderness for a long time. Today the Lord is looking at you, the power and fire of the Lord is upon you, so you are going to have a breakthrough. Hallelujah. Brother Carlos Veloz, the financial deliverance I see. Hallelujah. Shakar in this debate. And the Lord is, Charlotte Down sister, the Lord is increasing your knowledge. The wounds are healed, sister Charlotte. Down, sister. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Rabba Shakaram this tebe. The allowance, a promotion. Sister Remia Rai, I see a promotion, something allowance. You are getting a financial allowance. I hear like that. Hallelujah. Brother Juan Chavas, I see the breakthrough. Breakthrough from your parental side. I see a breakthrough from your parent. The breakthrough is coming through your parental side, from your father's side. I see a breakthrough coming. Shakaram. It is related to the family setup. God is setting the family in the right position, Brother Juan Chavas, and God is giving you more knowledge and power. The Lord is guiding you. The Lord is telling you how to move. Hallelujah. Shakaram diste lama. Hallelujah. So those who believe in the power of God, today morning, today evening, wherever you are, you are seated in the right place. The enemy might be chasing you. You are in the wrong place. But today the enemy cannot hold you back. So I am going to pray for you. I am going to pray for everyone. How many of you believe? It depends upon your faith. If you believe today, now it is the time for deliverance. So let us close our eyes to pray. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, touch everyone. Let heaven be open. Let the fire of God God be released. Let the fire of God be released. Let the power of God be released. Let everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Lord, we give you all the honor to you. Thank you, Lord, for guiding us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is telling and there is a promotion. Hallelujah. Optional birth. I see Oshakar and this Deva. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. An optional birth. Hallelujah. An optional birth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, reveal about it. Oshakaram Disteve. So it is upon your choice. You have the choice. The Lord is saying it is an optional. There is something going to birth in your life. Something is going to start in your life. Something is going to give life into your ministry. So something is going to it is going to birth something. It is going to start something. Something is going to be created which you have nothing in your life. So when you open your mouth, it is going to create. It is going to create. Hallelujah. Something, Sister Norma Gaza, I hear something is going to be born in you. Right? Holy Spirit is saying, what you have nothing at this moment, but God is going to make it create. You are open your mouth and declare it. Hallelujah. I see the Lord is giving you a house also. The Lord is giving you a house, Sister Norma Gaza. Hallelujah. Shakar in Dostube. So, Lord, let everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Signing the agreement. Jenin Dolo. Jenin, sister, I see you signing the. Maybe you are, I sense that you are somewhat like exited from your own house. Maybe. Maybe you are in the house, but you feel like you are outside the house. So today the Lord is signing an agreement. So the Lord is going to give a breakthrough. The Lord is going to give a breakthrough in your life, Sister Jenny. Hallelujah. Shakar in this day, nebe. So more connections coming. John Hubert, brother, the Lord is saying more connections coming. The ministerial connections. The Lord is connecting you with the many holy men of God. Brother John Hubert. Hallelujah. Rabba Shakaram Dishtebe. Lord, let everyone be filled and everyone know the power of God. Maybe you have been reading the Bible for a long time, but you have seen the verses, but you are saying that I have not seen any miracle from these words. But today, the word you believe is going to do. Brother Brian Hard, you are saying, I sense that you are saying that you are not seeing any miracle. But today, the word which you have read in the Bible is going to do a miracle in your life. Brother Brian Hard, I sense like that. Oh, Shakaram Distube. Oh, Rikinaba. Lord, let the power of God come upon everyone. Shikirindu Stebe. Hallelujah. The Lord's favor is upon everyone. Dilkaram Astikti Ruba. Shikina, in the name, the Lord is writing something in the New Ink. Sister Paul Helenok. Paul Helenok. The Lord is writing a new chapter in the New Ink. This is what I see. The Lord is writing something new in the new ink. It is, that means you have not what you have not seen, what you have not imagined. So it is in the new form. It is in the new form. I see you are journeying. I see you are journeying. You are in search of something. The Lord is saying, what you are searching. What I see like that you are searching for a stability. So the Lord is saying, the Lord is writing something in the new ink. In the new ink that you have never imagined. What you have been searching, it is going to come in the new form. Sister Paul Helenok. Paul, Helen, no, hallelujah. The mercy of Shakaram, this day, Lama. Lord, touch everyone, bless everyone. The Lord is going to bring a breakthrough. Hallelujah. Breakthrough. Hallelujah. The Lord is going to give a breakthrough to everyone. Everyone. Those who are saying, I am in under a captive. I am a captive. I want a deliverance in certain area. Maybe you are a minister of God. Maybe you are a father or a mother. Or you are leading a family. Or you are doing a ministry. Or doing a business. Everything is going well. But in one area of your life, God has hidden it from other people, but you want to come out of it. You want to come out, you need a deliverance in that area. So today, if you believe in the power of God, you are delivered. You are delivered in that area which you cannot come out. Because when you believe in the faith, in the power of God, the power of God will come upon you and deliver you from that area which you cannot come out, because it is impossible for you to stay in that situation. Hallelujah. Acts 2:24 says Jesus was raised because it was impossible. It was impossible. Maybe somebody who is watching somebody who is watching the videos, somebody who is addicted to many bad habits, somebody who is addicted to bad habits, somebody who is watching the videos and crying to God, Lord, I need a deliverance. I want to come out, because the enemy, whenever you open your system, whenever you open the media, the system, the enemy is trying to entice you. So somebody is crying, I want to come out from this situation. I need a deliverance. So when you believe in the power of God, when you believe in the faith, in the power of God, it is impossible for you to stay in that situation. How many of you believe? It is impossible. Maybe the enemy has been circling you, has been making you a fool and making you tempted in that way for a long time, for many years. But today is the breakthrough, because it is impossible for you to stay in that situation. Jesus, the enemy thought that they guarded, the Jews guarded the soldiers in front of the king. They sealed the cave. They thought that when they put the guard on the cave, they thought that Jesus cannot come out. But it was impossible. It was impossible for Jesus to stay. Likewise, the enemy may be trying for many long years. The enemy may be tempting. And something in your secret life, something in your personal life that you want to come out, but you cannot come out because the enemy was making you a fool. But today, when you believe that it is impossible to stay in that situation, because you have the anointing, you have the calling, you have the great calling, you have the anointing, so it is impossible to stay in that situation. You are going to do miracles. You are going to do mighty wonders. You are going to do many, many miracles in your ministry, in your business, in your family, wherever you go. The miracles will follow you. So it is impossible for you to stay in that situation. How many of you believe? So you believe in the power of God. God is releasing, God is anointing, and God is giving you a breakthrough in that area which you cannot come out. Hallelujah. So today, everyone, if you believe, everyone is having a breakthrough, because you are going to sit in the right position. O Shakaram Tisteva, you are going to, Sister Daira Eva, you are going to sit in the right seat, not in the wrong seat. I see many chances have come before, but the enemy was not making you to sit there, but today, because you believe in the power of God, you are going to sit, you are going to get that office, you are going to get that house. I see like that, Sister Daira, you are Shakarindustu Lema. In the name of Jesus, Lord, touch everyone, bless everyone. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. It is a breakthrough. It is a breakthrough for everyone, for everyone. The Lord is lifting you in your own place. Hallelujah. Mona told the sister, the Lord is saying, in your own place, the Lord, maybe you have passed through many tests. And maybe you are not located in the right place. I sense, but the Lord is locating you in the right place. The right thing is coming in your life. Hallelujah. Shakala. More grace. Lena Grava, sister. More grace. Lena Grava. I see the financial breakthrough. Lena Grava. The Lord is giving you, Shandy Mondoria, sister. The Lord is giving you more knowledge. When you have the knowledge, you will have the breakthrough. Because of the lack of knowledge, the Ephesians church had no deliverance. So Paul prayed for the people to have understanding, knowledge, to have the knowledge of God. So when they had the knowledge, they got deliverance. Sister Shandy Mondaria, sister, the Lord is giving you knowledge. That knowledge will give you deliverance. Hallelujah. The door is open for you. Hallelujah. So it is Norma Gaza, sister, the door is open for you. Lord, touch everyone. Bless everyone in the name of Jesus. Nobody can sit in the old seat anymore. It is impossible. It is impossible to be in the lockdown throughout your life. Somebody is saying, I heard many people saying, it will be lockdown for many years. We have to wear the mask always. Somebody is saying, but I prophesy in the name of Jesus. I declare in the name of Jesus, it is impossible for you to stay in that situation. So those who believe, the Lord is arranging new things. The Lord is arranging new things. Sister Ramya Rai, the Lord is saying it is impossible. It is impossible to stay you in that position. So the Lord is doing a miracle in your life. Hallelujah. 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 Shakaran Dusebe. In the name of Jesus, Apostle Jacqueline Smith, it is impossible, impossible to stay in that situation. The Lord is giving you a breakthrough. What you are praying at this moment, the Lord is granting you. I see something is burning in your heart. You have a prayer request. What you are, the God is in control, and what you are praying, it is granted, Sister Apostle Jacqueline Smith. It is granted. You will see that miracle. In that day, you will see that miracle. Shakaram Distube. Hallelujah. I see a promotion, Sister Faith Edwards. I see many children. Many children, Sister Faith Edwards. Their children are going to college. I see like that. They are getting the admission. They will get the right seats. Sister Faith Edwards, they will get the right seat in the college. I sense like that. So need not to be worried. Shakarin Duste Bayle Kuruba. Lord bless everyone. Touch everyone. The Lord is blessing everyone. The Lord is hallelujah. Many times you have been asking Yashika Mehata. I see that you have torn many papers, many times prayed and many times tried, but not seen a deliverance. But if you believe in the power of God, if you believe in the word of God, if you believe in the power of Jesus, I see what you have lost, you are going to get back the same seat. The peace of the Lord is upon you. The grace of the Lord is upon you. And God is giving you more tolerance. And you are reaching into the next level. Yasikya Mahata. So I sense you have been locked down for a long time. The Lord is breaking the chains. And I see the provision. You don't lack anything. I see the provision. I see you filled with the Holy Spirit. The Lord is watching. The Lord is watching you, sister Yasika Mahata. So very soon there will be a travel. Very soon there will be a travel. And it will be, you are waiting for a travel. I sense like that. I see you with the luggage. You have the passport in your hand. Hallelujah. The Lord is showing me a country, Singapore. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One of your cousins will help you. I sense like that. Lord, touch everyone in the name of Jesus. Oh, Shakara. Lord, fill everyone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, bless everyone in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Fill everyone with the power of God. Fill everyone with the fire of Lord. Let everyone be healed. If anyone is having any pain in the body right now, be healed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord has released His healing power. Lift up your hands and receive the healing power. The healing power is coming upon everyone. Breaking the chains, breaking the curses. O Shakarin Turebe. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah, the arthritis healed, hallelujah, hallelujah. What that is abnormal is healed, I see a healing coming upon you, Brother Brian Hart. I see a healing come out upon you. Hallelujah. More grace upon you, Shakar, in this day. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Let Lord fill everyone. Let Lord touch everyone. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I built a fence of fire around everyone. Let everyone be promoted to the next level. Be transferred into the next level. Thank you, Lord, for the clarity in every sense. Thank you, Lord, for ministering. Thank you, Lord, for everything. In Jesus' name, amen. So I am humbled. I thank everyone, those who are watching and will be watching later. So what I was ministering, those who have come later, I am telling, I was ministering from the book of Ephesians 1, 19 and 20, by faith in the power of God. If you believe in the power of God, you cannot stay in the old position. You cannot, the enemy cannot make you stagnant. The enemy cannot stay you in the old position. So surely there will be a promotion. If you believe right now, if you believe today, I see everyone, today there will be a movement. Because you cannot stay back. You cannot stay in the old position. So get ready for the new position. Move into the new position. Hallelujah. So I will be coming on live next week, same time in this group. I'm humble. So well, I bless all the leaders of this group. I bless all the brothers and sisters, those who are watching. May the grace of God abound in you, and you are going to move into the next level, because you cannot stay in that old position anymore time. Surely there is a deliverance. So God bless everyone. Jesus' name, amen.